guys, thank you so much for all of your love for the GMAT study plan video. A lot of you came back asking for a GRE study plan. Now, I haven't given that exam, so I don't know how exactly to tackle the concepts and the various things that come with it. But I do know someone who did give the exam and managed to score an amazing number. So today I have my first guest on my YouTube channel. Hi, Swapnil.
Hi.
Thank you so much for agreeing to be here on my YouTube channel and share your tips and tricks on how you managed to crack the GRE exam with an amazing score. A lot of our viewers are prepping for their GRE right now and they would love to hear all of these tips and tricks that you applied to score beyond 325, which is like a dream for a lot of people. So why don't you tell me how and when you decided to give the GRE exam?
So I always wanted to pursue my master's in technology and I thought it would be a good idea to get some experience working in the industry before I pursued my master's. I think it was a couple of years into work when I decided to take the GRE exam. If I had to guess the exact month, I think it was somewhere around January or February of 2016.
And then how did you finalize your exam date? Did you just go about studying and then, you know, book an exam after you were done studying? Or did you fix a deadline and then work towards it?
So in my case, what had happened was I wanted to leave enough time for preparing my entire application. And I know these exams like GRE and TOEFL are more of a cutoff than a make it or a break it situation. What will make or break your application is usually your statement of purpose or your letters of recommendations, which matter more. So I wanted to get these things out of the way as soon as possible. So I made my mind to give these exams somewhere around mid-July or September, which is usually early for some applicants. But I wanted to leave like an error of margin in case I don't get a good enough score. In which case I can like take the exam again.
Agreed, and that's such a smart approach. In fact, even in my GMAT study plan, I had put it out there that, you know, once you fix a deadline, in all probability, be prepared that you might have to give the exam again if it doesn't go well. So that was a really smart approach. What study materials did you use and how did you manage to study?
I didn't use any extra materials like out of the usual stuff that most students usually follow, your typical Barron's and the official guide, which is I followed. One resource was very helpful, which was Magoosh. It came highly recommended from a common friend of ours. Shout out to him, he knows who he is, and it was really very helpful. Apart from that, I had a couple of mobile apps which are like flashcards, which help you like revise concepts whenever on the go. So that was another thing that I used.
Any specific apps that you might want to recommend for flashcards and such?
I think Magoosh themselves had like an app which is obviously free. You don't need to like take that or like subscribe to download them or like use them. Apart from that, there are plenty resources, like free resources on the internet. I don't remember any particular ones as of such, but yeah, Magoosh is one of them which I stand by.
Right. And I just want to make it clear here that we are not trying to promote Magoosh. This is not an advertisement or a promotion. It's just that it really helps Swapnil. And in fact, after his success with GRE, he recommended Magoosh to me. And then I went on to buy it for my second attempt at the GMAT. So thank you so much, Swapnil. That really changed my entire approach and everything. Next thing was, while you were studying, you were also actually working full time. So how did you happen to manage your time and your schedule?
So like you mentioned in your earlier videos, once you take the exam date, it's just pretty much at the back of your head every single time. So once I booked my exam date, every single time that I wasn't working or like doing daily chores, I was studying. So I used to squeeze in any time that I could to solve questions or like revise concepts from like usual travel time in like buses when we used to travel from work to home or like home to work. That was spent on revising. I used those flashcard apps that I just talked about to revise like GRE vocabulary words.
So basically it was just like any time that you could get, you were dedicating it to GRE. And I think that level of commitment is required. In fact, even in my GMAT study plan video, I'd said about how I was having fixed work hours and then everything apart from those work hours used to be on GMAT. I'd like put aside family time, meeting friends, recreational activities, and just put all of it aside. And I think that really matters, right? because once you're committed to something, you'll have to put in that time and effort if you want to see the results. Okay, and how often did you take mocks? As in, it's really important to have those checkpoints to understand, right, whether you are actually improving or not. So how often did you take mocks?
So the first mock that I took was day one. After that, I didn't take any mocks until 1 month before the exam. And then after that, I just focused more on taking mocks rather than studying new concepts, because the time before that was spent on revising all the entire concepts that I was weak at. And then it was time to put whatever I had studied into practice.
And you said that you weren't making, studying any new concepts, especially like 1 month before the exam. So, and you had also mentioned that you were studying by commuting and other such times. So did you happen to make any notes or journal those topics? Because it's important to revise all of those at some point, right?
I agree, but I am guilty of not making any notes, like, because GRE was just always at the back of my head. I was kind of lazy in making notes, so I didn't make any, because I kind of trusted my brain to just make those decisions for me at the time. But having said that, that's a me thing, and it might not work for everyone else.
Yeah, that's true. In fact, when I was studying for my GMAT, I made like aggressive notes. I had sections of different topics in my book, and I used to make very aggressive notes. So to whoever is watching this video, if you are somebody who likes making notes and who likes to write things down, please go ahead and do make notes. That really helps in revisions. But if you are a superhuman like Swapnil is, and you feel that, you know, you can just remember stuff, feel free to not make notes. It's totally a very personal choice. Okay, what was your strategy for 1 week before the exam and 1 day before the exam?
So, like most people tend to do, I didn't focus much on the AWS section, and I realized maybe I should pay some more attention towards that. So I think a week before the exam, or like a week and a half before the exam, I reduced the time I was spending on like just solving questions to like reading essays. Even here, me being me, I didn't exactly practice writing my essays. I just kind of read them, taking mental notes while I was reading them about what are the parts I should focus on. But again, like if writing works more for you, you should definitely practice writing essays.
Yeah, that's an interesting point. In fact, even for my GMAT, I started working on AWA and IR just a week before the exam. When I was taking mocks, that is when I would actually deliberately take that AWA section and practice writing, because then it just gives you that entire feel of the true exam. What was your approach for the day of the exam? Were you feeling nervous, excited?
So on the day of the exam, stress is definitely one word that I was feeling. In my head, I was just making sure that I was well versed with all the stuff that I had studied. There was nothing that I needed to revise again. The way I did that was by revising every single thing again and again and again. Just making sure, hey, do I know that formula? Or hey, do I remember the meaning of that particular word?
So just like giving yourself a random test of sorts, yeah. By yourself?
Yeah, something like that. But it was just non-stop. It wouldn't stop. Even if I wanted to, it just wouldn't.
So it was just like running on autopilot mode?
Yeah. Be my
So then, did you have any specific approach going into the exam center? As in, did you give yourself a pep talk or anything like that?
Well, not a pep talk, but I remember just before I entered the exam room, like a huge sigh. It sounds very cinematic or like dramatic, but this is exactly what happened.
How did you feel when you saw the exam score on the screen? What was your feeling?
So the first thing is, like, as soon as the number popped up, I couldn't believe, because that score was higher than any of the mock scores that I had. So it took a while for my brain to register that this was actually real. Once I registered that, I just couldn't stop smiling. Like, finally, all those months of preparation had like bore a fruit.
That's like certainly amazing. Scoring something higher than you've ever scored in any of your mocks, it's a feeling of exhilaration and excitement. Any advice or suggestions for the GRE test takers who are preparing right now?
At the risk of sounding like a broken record, just practice, practice, practice. that is what is going to help you at the end of the day. Knowing where you stand, what your weakest points are, and being ready to push yourself to attack those weakest points is a battle half won already. And if you're looking for a more structured way of preparing for your exams, I would recommend all the people to watch your GMAT videos, because a lot of those concepts directly translate to GRE preparation.
Yeah, so if any of you are actually looking for a proper study plan or a schedule of like how I managed during my GMAT preparation, I would strongly recommend that you watch the GMAT study plan video. You can check out the link here, or I have also mentioned the link in the description box. Do you want to give it a try to request people to subscribe to the channel, because we are almost close to 1,000.
Alright guys, if you like the video and if you like the conversation and if you think this is going to help you in your GRE preparation, please like, share and subscribe. Let's make Madhuri reach 1,000 subscribers soon.
Thank you, Swapnil, once again for appearing on the video. And to all of you guys out there preparing for the GRE, here's a huge bucket full of wishes from me and Swapnil. Hope you get the score that you desire and all the best for your master's journey as well. Thank you for watching.